The University of Alabama at Birmingham is the largest employer of the state of Alabama. It has about 18,000 students, and it has approximately $5 billion of annual impact of the economy of the state of Alabama. The Minority Health and Health Disparity Research Center is a comprehensive center, or as you may say, the umbrella of health disparities research and outreach and training for the University of Alabama at Birmingham. UAB is in the middle of the Mid-South region, or the Deep South, where there the high burden of disease and a gap between health outcomes and incidence of disease between minorities and non-minority majority populations. Also, it's in the middle of the Deep South, where more than 50% of the African Americans population live in the United States, an emerging Hispanic population. So UAB, with its talents and skills and knowledge and resources, it is one of our ethical duties or roles to address health disparities in this region. When we first started to apply for grants for health disparities, we started with a small project that was $50,000. Now, for UAB, we were able to get funding to conduct health disparities research with close to $80 million. These are all grants that they address health disparities in cancer, in diabetes, in obesity, in heart disease. We focus also on African American men's health. We focus on policy, but also we focus on what we call social determinants of health. The three goals of the MHRC are advancing the science of health disparities, developing the pipeline of our future scientists, minority and non-minority, to work in this field. And third, linking with the community and be the venue or the linkage between the community and academic researchers.
The UAB Patient Navigation Services is a free service at UAB Comprehensive Cancer Center that supports cancer patients going through clinical trial or just standard treatment. The navigators have become part of the healthcare team. That means that the physicians and other healthcare workers look to the navigators to provide that support and bridge the gap between the patient and the healthcare system.
The UAB navigation program is extremely helpful for patients and for physicians. It helps patients because for them, in this complicated world, it's very difficult to navigate through the different steps in order to get the health care that they require.
Well, I really enjoy the opportunity to work with patients. Not only do I get a chance to see them transform from the diagnosis, but I also get to provide a resource. We become that bridge of communication. We become their eyes. We become their ears. We become a shoulder that they can lean on when they're going through such a difficult time. And we become a team. And I think that's why it's so important to have this program, to make sure that people from the outside come in and feel like not only they're cared for, but they're part of a team that wants to help them.
One of the projects that has been going on for more than a decade is the racial and ethnic approaches for community health that has been funded by CDC. And it started with, with phase one, which was called REACH 2010. And REACH 2010 focused on rural communities to promote mammography screening among African American women. We moved to the REACH US, which are more of centers of excellence. They call them the seed centers. And then currently we are funded by CDC to conduct Birmingham REACH for Better Health. CDC main goal with this project is to go maybe wider and address policy, system, and environment. Because if we address policies, if we address systems and environment, we're gonna reach more people than addressing individuals.
The Birmingham REACH for Better Health program is a CDC-funded initiative
designed to make healthy choices the easy choices. We're working in two vulnerable census tracts in Birmingham. We're working in Kingston and Avondale alongside great partners, Freshwater Land Trust, Jefferson County Department of Health, Rev Birmingham, Urban Food Project, United Way of Central Alabama, Safe Routes to School, and the YMCA. It's really important because these areas may be considered by some as a food desert. So we want to make sure that they do have access to healthy food choices and physical activity opportunities. We are a developed country, but we have pockets of developing countries in our communities. And we can learn from the work of global health. So what I would hope that we can be just without borders. MHRC would be a center without borders that can not only serve vulnerable populations in our country, but we can go globally. And maybe one day we'll eliminate health disparities and we'll be out of business. So this would be the best, goal ever.